got something special for you today. Bubba TV felt it necessary to drive all the way from Syracuse to Buffalo to catch the craft. You know, one thing about our society and one thing about our people is we really don't have any crafts. You know, what do we make with our hands? You know, rarely do we talk about alchemy. Alchemy being the thing that we take something out of nothing. So real quick, we just want to show you why Bubba TV found it necessary to come all the way to Buffalo to see the craft. What you call heirlooms. These are an heirloom is something that you can pass on to the next generation with a story. You know, so today when Bubba get his piece, he can say to his grandchildren or his nieces and nephews that came before him how he got the piece, where the piece come from, and most of all the significance of the piece.
What did say, Bubba TV?
Kemet.
That's right. That's right. But for those who don't know, they'll read it, K&T.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
No vowels.
No vowels, mm-hmm. Right? So this, so when you walk in the street, they say, Brother Kemet. That's a brother that know. Then opposed to KMT, what that stands for. You know, so it becomes Masonic when we wear our pieces. It becomes our brand. Because, you know, we RBG in this. You know what I'm saying? We revolutionary but gangster. You know, real black girls, writer's basic guideline, you know what I'm saying? Read about Garvey. This is what we do. You know what I'm saying? Wear Garvey around your neck. Become Garvey. Let's become Garveyites. You know, look out for the UNIA here in Buffalo. You know, we reinstituting the chapter and we coming soon. But yes, sir. You know, this is special right here because the dog tag got his name on it. You know, and the birth and going home date. You know, so these are one of a kind pieces. Dr. Khaled. You know, and not to mention, Bubba, before I forget, it got inscriptions in the side. Dr. Khaled Muhammad. This one on the side, Dr. Khaled Muhammad. If y'all can see. It's the RBG piece. These are the official RBG rings. RBG got the RBG sign in the inside. We could put RBG Sankofa, RBG Imhotep, RBG Shaka, you know, whoever. We got a whole host of rings. You know, cultural rings, stones. You want to support black, you like looking flashy, you want to make a statement, you know, in your jewelry, this is where you can get it. I'm going to say it slow. 716-486-44. I'm in Buffalo, New York. I'm Shango Oya. You know, just ask for me and go through the page on Facebook and pick out something you want. You know, inbox me. Let me know. Take back what's ours. You know, the Jews and all other ethnic groups got hand in our precious metals and making our jewelry. And you know, white man wake up and he just makes up the cost of gold and copper and silver, you know. But it's time for us to gather together and, you know, boycott those things and start buying from people like Samaj, people like from Amin-Ra, you know, such as myself, and whatever we can provide. But that's all I got for y'all for as of right now. The next time Bubba come, I'll definitely have something different because I'm always growing my collection, you know. But for now, peace and love, Hotep, Black Power.
All right, family. Greetings. Welcome to another edition of Bubba TV Every Time Fire. Am I on? Yes, I'm on. On this most glorious day, the Earth Day, the birthday of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, the father of the Black Nation. And I'll speak for myself that back when I was young, and I think a lot of us can relate, and we didn't have nothing to fight with. This Caucasian fed us on the diet of Black mental inferiority from the religion, his curriculum, and everything else. We were picked on, ridiculed, scorned, mocked, abused by unscrupulous people, and they do it still today. They didn't give a damn about us. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad came with the antidote. Not no feel good, but actual facts, supreme mathematics. This mighty Black man. Shout out to his students, Minister Farrakhan, Malcolm X, Clarence 13X. These are his students that he made. We worship and honor the students, but we want to talk about the father, the one that taught Malcolm X, the one that taught Clarence 13X, the one that taught Minister Louis Farrakhan, taught Khalid Abdul-Muhammad, taught the Honorable Melchizedek, who you will be hearing from just in a couple minutes. I don't want to lose my thoughts, but the honor, I read the message to the Black man. He gave me the strength and the tools to stand up and beat the hell out of this Caucasian. You know, the white man, he hit us with that venom, that snake, that poison. And Elijah had the serum to inject in them, not no can't we get along-ism. Hell no. He gave us, you know, when a snake bites you and you go to the doctor to get healing, they give you that same poison in a serum so you can, until you reach balance in the system. He lifted us up with truth. Pull that Caucasian down. Beat him down with actual facts and the truth. He made fun of our lips, the Caucasian, our hair, the dark, beautiful complexion of our skin. Said that we were close to the monkeys. And Elijah said, if you take the hair off that ape and shave it off the hair of that, you shave the hair of that ape, it's pale under there. You see that white woman, she flat in the back, a flat gluteus maximus. Elijah beat the hell out of them. He hurled truth at falsehood. Now you crying, white folks. You mean to tell me you can't take what you dish out? Elijah Muhammad taught us how to fight and stand up and made us a self-respecting people and busted up that mental inferiority imposed on us by the Caucasian. I don't want to hear no crying. Don't cry today, white folks. Don't cry today. Elijah was the wisest of them all. He had farmland, hospitals, restaurants. And he was the most, you all hated him, but you couldn't do, speaking to white people now, you couldn't do nothing with him. I'm done talking. I just want to say happy birthday to the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. Happy birthday, Honorable Elijah Muhammad, to all of the followers who have suffered, especially the original ones of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. Thank you for suffering, persevering throughout America, white racist America, to make sure that we got this teaching. And I want to especially thank the man that I'm going to bring before you today for keeping his teaching strong, keeping the nation of God's and Earth's Clarence 13X, the father, when the teaching went by the wayside. This brother, this elder, this mighty man kept the teachings strong, kept it alive among the gods. You go ask the gods of Earth today about Melchizedek. He kept all the teachings alive amongst and had to suffer. Sat in the classroom, the man that I'm about to present, with Malcolm X, with Clarence 13X, with Minister Louis Farrakhan at Mosque Number 7 in Harlem, New York City. Tomorrow, and Melchizedek will elaborate further. I just want to say a little something. It was supposed to be today, but due to the inclement weather, it was postponed till tomorrow at 2 o'clock on 127th Street. Will be renamed after the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad. The street naming, you see it right there, family. The unveiling ceremony. Shout out to the organizers of this. You know, Harlem always got, you know, Harlem loved to name the streets after our greats. And the Honorable Elijah Muhammad should have been had his place, but better late than never. He got it on 127th Street. It will be tomorrow at 2 o'clock. Those of you in the New York City area, tri-state area, and if you can travel outside and make it, come on. It's going to be a glorious and wonderful celebration, family. With that being said, I want to present to some and introduce to others the Honorable Melchizedek, Supreme Shabazz Allah, Universal High Priest of the Nation of Islam on Earth and in the universe. I'm going to shut my mouth and let the teacher go on and teach. Receive him, family. Go ahead, Melchizedek. You live. Your mic is on, sir.
Okay. Well, Bob, I appreciate you. I appreciate you, bro. That's a beautiful introduction you give. I'm telling you, I feel it all the way here in Medina. Listen. All praise due to Allah. In the most holy name of Almighty God, Allah, who came in the person of Master W.D. Farad Muhammad, the only God, and besides him, there is no God. So if you're worshiping another God besides him, you're just wasting your time and making a fool out yourself, okay? And his last, greatest, and only messenger, there's only one Allah in the person of Master Farah Muhammad, the universal divine supreme being, and only one messenger, the most honorable Elijah Muhammad, okay? The last, greatest, and only messenger of Allah. I'm so happy today just to represent my father, the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. Happy birthday. Happy birthday, dear holy apostle. It's a pleasure to be your spiritual son. It was a pleasure for me to stand by you all these years and uphold the teachings of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad, word for word, right and exact. I never changed. I never changed it. Just like he said it, word for word, right and exact. Don't add to it and don't take away from it. Just the way I've been doing it for the last 63 years. Never fell victim, okay? Everybody knows that, so I ain't got to go into that. But anyway, happy birthday, dear Holy Apostle, the most honorable Elijah Muhammad, like I have said before, lives forever, forever, okay, in the mind of the true believer, who bear witness that Almighty God Allah came to person Master W.D. Farad Muhammad, uphold his teachings, receive his teachings, uphold his teachings, and carry his teachings into practice to the best of their ability, word for word, right and exact. Don't add to it. Don't take away from it, just like he said it. When you see that believer, you're looking at the messenger. The most honorable Elijah Muhammad is worldwide. Okay? All the true believers is Elijah. He's in the minds of all the true believers. Okay? That's why he's forever. It's not no more one Elijah. It's a nation. I want you to understand that. It's not no more one Elijah. It's a nation of Elijahs. And when you have a nation of Elijahs, no one person is in charge of the nation. It's a nation of Elijah. And we come together in unity, love, respect, and uphold his teachings word for word, right and exact. Don't add to it. Don't take away from it. If you try to add to it or try to take away from it, all you're doing is making a fool out yourself, because the world knows his teachings is right and exact, and no adding to it, no taking away from it, and that's all documented. Okay? Now, when I'm speaking, I speak to the world. One foot on land, one foot on the sea. Okay? North, west, east, and south. I speak to the CIA. I speak to Homeland Security. I speak to the Nation of Gods and Earth, the Nation of Islam, whatever organization or nation is out there. When I speak, I'm speaking to you, and I'm a part of all that. Because who is the original man? Age-added black man, owner, maker, peanut planet Earth, the father of civilization, God of the universe. Now, we recite who is the original man. But who is he? Who is he? We know he's original. We know he's a father. Well, let's give him his proper universal identification. When you say the original Asiatic black man, you know who you're speaking of? You're speaking of the universal most high God, Shabazz. Don't forget that. Shabazz Allah. Okay? Now, we'll go walk a little bit with the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. What makes him so powerful? What makes him so recognized? He wasn't just the messenger of America. He's the messenger of the world. And I can say he's the messenger of the world, okay? Because the only two individuals that's more effective, more recognizable, more acceptable, more well-known, it's only two that you can give that universal high recognition and respect and credit to. And that's Almighty God Allah, who came to person Master W.D. Farad Muhammad, and his last and greatest messenger, the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. There's nobody on earth, hear me, nobody on earth can wear those shoes. Nobody can put on the shoe of Master W.D. Farad Muhammad because you don't qualify. Nobody can put on the shoes of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad because you don't qualify. So just be grateful and be appreciative that you had opportunity to receive this universal, the universal divine supreme knowledge with understanding that came down from the universal most high God, okay, to the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. And he alone, as you know, was going all around the country for 7 years, okay, being so-called chased by hypocrites. He wasn't, hypocrites don't fear. The most honorable, a believer don't fear hypocrites. Because all hypocrites, bloodsuckers and hypocrites is nothing but a bunch of punks. That's why they run their mouth. Anytime you see them, they got a group. When you God, you don't need nobody. You roll by yourself. You don't need nobody. But it may make a long story short. I'm not going to go into all that. I just want to took this day to honor and praise my father, my spiritual father, the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. And I would like for everybody to say, all over the world, north, west, east, and south, one foot on land, one foot on the sea, let's just say, happy birthday, dear holy apostle, Allahu Akbar. As-salamu alaykum. Okay. All right. Now, today, I named this The Fall of America. We call it The Fall of America. And those who fell in America. Okay. Now, as you know, a lot of immigrants from around the world is flocking to the New York area. I should say America, not just New York, Chicago, North Carolina, South Carolina, or wherever they can fit in. Okay. This is a sign to let you know how important the teachings of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad is. Because the only way to survive this crisis that's coming through, I can speak for New York because we're here. That we're here. It's coming through. It's going to be a big burden on the citizens of New York. Okay. Because when you got thousands and thousands of people coming in and hardly no place for them to stay, no food, no clothing, no shelter, it can be a very destructive situation. You know what I'm trying to say? And this is why I was encouraging y'all over the years. You want all of the teachings of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad in your house, because you're not going to be coming out. Okay, when this thing hit the fan, you're going to be in your house. And while you're in your house, you want to be you want to have everything you need to keep your mind sane. So you won't lose your mind, you understand? And the only thing that keep your mind sane, so you won't lose your mind, is the teachings of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad. Okay? This is what you need in your house. Okay? So I'm explaining that to you. And so take advantage of it while the opportunity is there, because it's not going to always be there. And if you neglect yourself from these teachings or let other hypocrites block you from getting these teachers, anybody who tries to block you or interfere with you receiving the publications and the teachings of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, word for word, right and exact, don't add to it, don't take away from it, like he said it, that is a hypocrite and a bloodsucker, okay? And you never have to be afraid of a hypocrite or a bloodsucker. All hypocrites, all bloodsuckers, all bullies are punks. When you stand your ground with these teachings of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, you'd be surprised how fearless you are and how destructive you can be. So don't never worry about a bloodsucker, never worry about a hypocrite, and never worry about a bully. They are punks, weak. As long as you stay focused on the teachings of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, word for word, right and exact, don't add to it, don't take away from it. Just like he said it, that's when you are God. And God, as you know, means power and force. Okay? So anyway, now, today I want to talk about this school system. I listened to Umar Johnson, and he was explaining how in the schools, I mean, not just him and the yellow, Geno Jennings out there in Philadelphia, Christian preacher, coming down. Now they're trying to introducing homosexuals in the school system, in the elementary schools, while they're trying to direct them into little girls wanting to be little boys and little boys wanting to be little girls. You understand what I'm trying? This is trying to make this legal, and they're going all over the world with this. Because I mean, I think the presidents and so forth is trying to introduce this to the African countries, and then all the African countries that reject that foolishness, then they put a ban on them for whatever supplies or material or whatever they're getting, they put a ban on, so they won't threaten them that they will cut them off whatever they were receiving. Now, my point is this: where's all these preachers? Where's all these religious leaders when it comes to homosexuality being taught to young children, your children, young children, grandchildren, great grandchildren in the school system, and you never have nothing to say? You don't open your mouth. You just remain quiet. All you focus on is continue running that those scriptures, those lying scriptures. All you want to do is talk about the Bible or the Quran. Why you don't address the serious problem of homosexuality in the school system? I mean, you fell down that low where you don't even care nothing about the young generations come behind you, which is your children, grandchildren, or great-grandchildren. So you're, in other words, by you keeping your mouth shut and not speaking about it, exposing it, like a Umar Johnson, I give him respect. He's doing an excellent job. And Geno Jennings, if you haven't seen the one that Geno Jennings did in Washington, D.C., you go on my Facebook, Melchizedek Shabazz Allah. I shared it. I want all of you so-called leaders and ministers out there to watch that. And you have nothing to say. I mean, you mean tell me you've been sleeping in the slave master bed that long that you don't have the strength to get out and stand up and represent your people and try to save this young generation from homosexual or that homosexual animalistic characteristics performance? Okay? So you should get involved. Okay? All the money you got can't save you. You got all your money in the slave master's bank just sitting there. Okay? All your contributions, all the donations, all the charity, everything of the poor believers you put in the slave master's bank, okay? And the slave master takes that money and putting up all these condos and houses and things all over the country in front of your face, okay, with the congregation's money, okay? And they can't even move in it when it's finished building it because they raise the rent is so high, the expense is so high, they can't afford to move in it. So that's the way of. But even though it was their money that made it happen and build it. So what are you saying? You're sleeping in the slave master's bank for so long that you don't even have the strength to get out to do something constructive for your people? You ought to be ashamed of yourself. But you're not going to get away. Okay? Because what good is it to gain the whole world and lose your soul? Everything you got, trust me, it's going to come right down in front of your face. Right down in front of your face with the twink of an eyelash. That's all. A hurricane, twink of an eyelash. Earthquake, twink of an eyelash. Snowstorm, twink of an eyelash. Okay? Rain, whatever. Allah, all got to do is blink and it wipe out cities, countries, flatten it, level it. Because this is what? The fall of America. You understand? So I suggest you, whatever time you have left, do something constructive for your people and stand up for the young generation. If you stand for the wrong, nothing can take place if you hand-pick Negroes don't go along with it. Anytime the system can do something and be successful, it's because all you hand-pick Negro leaders, clergy and so forth, because you go along with it. You go along to get along because you're worried about your little $2 that you got in the bank that you have no control over. That's why you have a problem trying to do something for your people in your community. You understand? Because you know you have no power. You have to get permission to use your money to do something constructive in the community for your people. Okay? Now, Mel, which way are you going? I'm going towards economics like I always do. Why is it with all these millions and billions of dollars that the rich people have, the ball players, rich, all the preachers, rich, all the musical world, rich, all the religious world, rich. Why do y'all have a problem of doing something in the community that you got the money out of? Now, every community, wherever there's a church, a mosque, a synagogue, a temple, or whatever, how come you can't establish a laundromat, the services for the community, a laundromat, a square block, a supermarket, a square block, a daycare center, a square block, a recreational center, a square block, a barbershop, square block, a dry cleaner? You got 1,000 suits and don't have a dry cleaner? What's the problem? You got the money. Service your community. Don't be afraid. You bear witness that Almighty God Allah came to person Master W.D. Farad Muhammad and his last and greatest and only messenger, the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. You got the long divine protection. And you carry those teachings into practice word for word, right and exact. Don't add to it. Don't take away just like he said it. You'll be successful. They never interfere with the messenger's economical program. He put all those up in front of your face and left it running. But being a lack of understanding and people falling down on their hands and knees and not standing up on the square like the messenger taught them, okay, to pray straight up, feet 45-degree angle, head slightly bowed, hand outstretched. That's how he taught us how to pray. You know that. So why would you allow yourself to fall down on the ground, okay? And if you fell down because you lack understanding and got weak, so after the snake died, all you had to do is get the hell back up. Just that. It's just that simple. See? When you fall, and everybody that went with Wallace fell, actual fact. Fine. Snake. Grab this snake, Wallace Jaco, you fell. Okay, mistake. Well, when he died, get back up and put everything back in place like it's supposed to be. He left you with temple. Put back temple. Left with Muhammad Speaks newspaper. Put back the Muhammad Speaks newspaper. Left with the blackboard in the temple. Put it back. All you gotta do, if you're going down the highway and you realize you're going the wrong way, you can always make a U-turn. You ain't got to continue in a negative direction, especially when you know you're going the wrong way. Just make a new turn. Allah is all wise, all beneficent, all merciful. You see what I'm saying? All you have to do, you understand, is stay focused on the teachings of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. Okay? Now, the two most powerfulest women on earth, I went into this before, is Queen Clara Muhammad and Queen Bernstein Sharif Muhammad. Those are the two most powerfulest black women on earth. And nobody is qualified to take their place. You can't match up to that. Why you say that, Melchizedek? Queen Clara Muhammad was taught face to face by Almighty God Allah, who came to person Master Farad Muhammad. Queen Bernstein was taught face to face by Almighty God Allah, who came to person Master Farad Muhammad. Those two women was the closest to Master Farad Muhammad. Okay. All the other women, queens, but they weren't that close. And Bernstein, right here, man, right there, when Almighty God Allah, in the person of Master W.D. Farad Muhammad, was putting his mind, check this out, his mind on paper, she was typing it to preserve it and make it available for us. Okay? And when the messenger was moving all around the country with those lessons, not no Quran, not no Hadith, lessons. Queen Clara Muhammad was holding together the best she could and just sharing the wisdom. And her right hand was Bernstein Sharif Muhammad. She made sure she had everything to supply amongst the believers to keep everybody together while the messenger was away for the 7 years. While they was taking care of their children, they had children. At the same time, Clara Muhammad accepted homeschooling, how to cook, how to sew. They were doing all that. You understand? Those two women should be taught. Their history should be taught for the elevation and motivation and determination for the NGT today. You got their history, understand their trials and tribulations. You're powerful now. You'll be more powerful than what you are now, because the past always gives strength to the present and the present gives strength to the future. Okay? Now, so here we are, faced with destruction, the fall of America. Okay? I got to give a shout out to the sister called the sister, I think Charlotte of, Sister by Nature, the canning. She has a canning program. She's on point. All you MGTs should take advantage of that opportunity. She's on point with the canning. Charlotte, Sisters by Nature. I watch her programs. She's on point. I mean, one time she said she registered about 30 sisters and only 7 came. She said that. I saw it on YouTube. I saw it. She said that. She registered 30 and only 7 come. What was the other 23 doing? Home watching videos or soap operas? Take advantage of that opportunity, because if you don't, you're going to wish you had. Because if you think all these people coming in here going to walk around with no food for their family and the supermarket is open, they're going to be in them supermarkets with baby carriages and strollers and walkers getting food for their family. So you ain't going to be able to be coming out in the street. Or even when you do come out in the street to go to the shopping, you're going to have somebody with you. Because they're going to be robbing the food off your shop, taking advantage of your shopping cart while you're on your way home with the food. So it's best you take advantage of that canning and stop trying to be all cute. Like, I don't do that. Or nails. I don't want to mess up my nails and all that kind of foolishness. You better take advantage of that and get into canning, because that's the name of the day. Canning is another word for preserving food so you have something to eat tomorrow when the catastrophe starts. That's what the essence of the meaning of canning. To have some food in your house to feed yourself and your babies when the catastrophe hit the street. Okay? All right. Now, and that should be taught. Okay? Bible and Quran is okay. But teach the survival. The survival kit. Okay. Now, brother called me up and said, Melchior, what do you got against prayer? I don't have nothing against prayer. I never leave my house without prayer. Let me explain to you all about prayer. When prayer is a personal, private communication between you and your Allah. When you in your home, you have all rights to pray any kind of way you choose to pray. You are mixed a lot and rock hots and all that. All that is highly respected in the privacy of your home, because prayer is a personal communication between you and Allah. You don't need nobody around you. You ain't got to go to no mosque or temple. You can go there for congregations. I'm just a congregation, hook up with brothers and sisters. But you ain't got to go nowhere. But there's no prayer on earth more powerful than when you in your home, okay, behind closed doors, and you on your prayer rug, rock hard, shallots, or whatever way you want to pray. You have the right to do that, because that's personal between you and your Allah. That's when you can feel the presence of Allah. When you're out there in public, playing with a big congregation, you got all kind of garbage. Everybody there is not a believer. You got homos there, lesbians. You got a whole lot of mixed up with a whole lot of garbage that you don't even know nothing about. Not everybody, don't get me wrong, but it's a mixture of everybody. So it's not of a higher state. You can't, it's not a prayer of righteousness. Okay? Because if you're mixed up with Satan, no way the prayer can be righteous. You understand what I'm trying to say? So that's why the messenger made it plain. The messenger, not Melchizedek, the messenger taught us how to pray. And everybody out there know that. Okay? Stand on the square. Straight up on the square. Your feet on the 45 degree angle. Head slightly bowed. And hands outstretched. That's the way the most honorable Elijah Muhammad, the last, greatest, and only messenger, taught us how to pray. And then he also said up the road, you don't pray to the east no more, we pray to the west. Because you all think the east is holy? You must have watched the news today. Gaza is bombing Israel right now, I'm telling you. Okay? There's no light in the east. All the lights in the west. That's why Almighty God Allah and the person of Master W.D. Farah Muhammad left the east. Because one left over there. And came here with the universal divine supreme knowledge with understanding. There's no wisdom on earth that can surpass the teachings of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. None. None, you hear me? I stand in front of the world. All I need is what? The supreme lessons from Master W.D. Farah Muhammad, lessons that he gave to his servant, the most honorable Elijah Muhammad, for the lost found nation of Islam in America? Don't lie on it. Every lost found in America has just as much access to that as anybody else. So nobody owns the teachings of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. Okay, everybody has a right to have it. Okay? And the message to the black man, message to the black man, I know, sure, you might not like it. Message to the black man, there's more wisdom in message to the black man than you got in the Quran and the Bible. More wisdom there in message to the black man got more wisdom in message to the black man than there is in the Quran and the Bible. Message to the black man make the Quran and the Bible look like a comic book, and the Hadith like a comic book, because they don't give life to the people. If those books gave life to the people, if that book of 1400 years ago, that one, in that Bible of 451 years, if it gave life to the people, the world wouldn't be in chaos now. The reason why the world is in chaos, the absence of truth, the absence of freedom, the absence of justice, and the absence of equality. That's the problem with the world. You understand what I'm just saying? The only teachings in the world is the teachings. Truth, teachings is the teachings of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad, word for word, right and exact. Don't add to it. Don't take away from it, just like he said it. Happy birthday, most honorable Elijah Muhammad. That's it. That's the only life-giving teachings in the world. All the other junk out there is no life-giving teacher. If it was, the world wouldn't be in the situation it is now. What happened? All the leaders, all these clericals, all these, they fell. Fell. What are you doing down here, Anthony? You fell. Why don't you just get up? All you gotta do is get up. When you get up, all you gotta do is what? Follow the teachings of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad, word for word, right and exact. Don't add to it. Don't take away from it, just like he said it. You ain't got no teaching on earth that gives life other than the teachings of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. None. Name me one. You got no man on earth producing giants like the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. Name me a man out there on earth, in America, or in Mecca. You ain't got nobody out there like that produce giants. There's no Malcolm without the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. The teachings made Malcolm the Malcolm that he was under his teachings. There's no Farrakhan out there. Okay? The teachings made Minister Farrakhan who he is. Muhammad Ali, the father of the gods and earth. Claude Carlet, Wallace. Name him, Mel Jedidic. None of us would exist at all. We all was deaf, dumb, blind, stupid, ignorant, unproductive, and a producer of nothing. Every motherfucker. So anybody out there think they got great off these teachings, got great without these teachings, you're a liar. You can't even open your mouth. I don't care who's out there. You can't open your mouth unless you quote the teachings of Most Honorable Elijah. If you don't use his name, you'll fall flat on your damn face. Everybody, me, you, and everybody else. And everything I say go for me too. I ain't leaving myself out. Today is his birthday, 126 years. Still going strong. Look at that. Name me somebody 126 years old. Look at that. Huh? And still going strong. Still got powerful, strong believers out here upholding his teachings. Okay? And you know it. Get back on track. Stop praying. And put one Allah. Almighty God, Allah, is the universal most high God in the person of Master W.D. Farad Muhammad. The Son of Man is Master W.D. Farad Muhammad. The Messiah is Master W.D. Farad Muhammad. The Christ, the Crusher, is Master W.D. Farad Muhammad. You put all those 99 attributes together, and all you can do is come up with Allah in the person of Master W.D. Farad Muhammad. Ain't but one Allah. Ain't but one messenger. Ain't but one Messiah. Ain't but one Christ. Did you want Melchizedek? You say you Melchizedek Shabbat Allah. From the Allah. You hear me? Without the teaching of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, there is no Melchizedek. Let me say that again. Without the teachings of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, there is no Melchizedek. Do you hear that? And without the teachings of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, anybody out there, you ain't nothing. I'm not nothing. And nobody else ain't nothing. But followers of the teachings of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad. I don't take no credit for not making it plain to the world. The Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad is my father. A father I always wanted. A father I always needed. A father I got to have. And a father I can't do without. I make that plain. And without the teachings of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, Melchizedek, Supreme, Shabbat, Allah, the High Priest, is just another nigga, because that's all the hell I was before I got the teachings. Get straight. I'm just your brother. Call me all up. Melt. I want to be just like you. I say, you're already like me. Just study the teaching of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad. Thank you for the wisdom. Thank you for this. I get calls all to 2 and 3 o'clock in the morning. Thank you, brother. Thank you. Don't thank me. Thank Master Farad Muhammad. I don't take no credit for nothing. I stay in my place. Because when you start taking credit for something, now you're getting stupid. Now you start making a fool out of yourself, and people start laughing at you. When you can go in a room with 1,000 people, you don't see the 1,000, but the 1,000 see you. There's a wide awakening all over the world. This is the day of the manifestation of all defects. To everybody that fell, get back up. If you're down on your hands and knees, stand up. The messenger didn't put you on your hands and knees. Wallace put you on your hands and knees. The messenger left us temples, not mosques. Tell me what he said, teaching and learning. Well, how you gonna pray and worship if you haven't been taught and learned? Now, this is no disrespect to nobody. I'm talking to everybody, including myself. But the only way you're going to survive the hell that's seeping through the nation is follow the teachings of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad, word for word, right and exact. Don't add to it. Don't take away from it. Just like he said it. That's the only thing that's going to save your soul. Now, if you think something else out there going to save it, go ahead. Be my guest. But all that other junk out there didn't stop you from being an alcoholic. It didn't stop you from being a junkie and a crackhead. It didn't stop you from eating pork. It didn't stop you. It didn't stop you when you out there weren't even taking a bath, walking around with holes in your shoes, funky and stinking. The messengers, teachings cleaned you up. The messengers, teachings made us what? Civilized. Who civilized us? The teachings of the most honorable moment. Okay? Civilized, cultured, refined, highly intelligent, neat, clean, and organized. Who did that? The teachings of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. Where did he get it from? From the Almighty God Allah, who came to personal master W.D. Farama. What's your problem? You can't change the word of God. How are you going to change the word of God? I'm this, I'm that. You ain't nothing. You ain't nothing. But whatever the teachings make you. If you follow the teachings of the most honorable Elijah, if we, I don't leave myself out. We, everything I say go for me too. So don't, I ain't trying to be over nobody. I'm just the brother, Melchizedek, Supreme, blah, blah, blah. That's all. What do you do, Melchizedek? Keep everything available to the best of my ability for the black people, for my people. That's all. That's all. I've published 16 books. I never asked you all for a dime. 16 books I published and got 2 more to go. Okay? Never asked you for a dime. Put the wisdom on my website. That website's been up for 23 years. I pay for it every month for 23 years of lessons on there to make sure it was safe for you all to have for the young generation. I never asked you for a dime. Okay? 23 years. You can go there, read it, make a printout copy. It's free. I pay for it for 23 years. Y'all got websites out there. You got a website. You're on website. You're on Facebook. You're on YouTube. You're on Twitter. Put the teachings on there. Flood mass media. Whatever teachings, lessons, whatever that you have of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad, word for word, right next to that, don't add to it, don't take away from what he said, put it on your website, put it on Twitter, put it on Instagram, put it on Facebook, put it on YouTube. All the teachings that you have of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad, you should flood that mass media with his teaching. If you flood that mass media with his teachings, you have a resurrection overnight. You take nice pictures. Nothing wrong with that. Put the lesson there too with your picture. I'm going to say that again. Whatever teachings that you have of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad, what he said, word for word, right next to that. Don't add to it. Don't take away from it. Just like he said it, put it out there. Flood mass media with it. All over YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, whatever, TikTok, whatever. What are you saving it for? What are you saving it for? What's the deal of a civilized man? Teach the uncivilized. Well, if you got something that's going to benefit them, make it available for them. It don't cost you nothing. You're on Facebook anyway. You're on YouTube anyway. You're on Twitter. You're on Instagram. You're on anyway. You can talk, make your little lectures and so forth, but put what the messenger said out there. I look at all y'all. I look at all these people. All over the place, talking. You resurrected Malcolm. Malcolm just alive today as he was yesterday. Everybody got to say about Malcolm for $2. You want to make $2? Speak on Malcolm. You got $2. But you don't even tell the good of Malcolm. I never hear y'all say how Malcolm established the teachings of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad in the prison system. Well, y'all don't say that. Why you don't say that? Why don't teach on that? It was Malcolm that came into the prison system with the articles of the Pittsburgh Courier and shared them with Brother Walter 5X, who rose to be Bilal Shabazz Shabazzallah and then Mukmarunza. How come y'all don't mention that? You run your mouth at everything else, but you don't say that. It was Malcolm. He did that. And I know that because I was there. That's how I came into the nation. Because if Malcolm didn't come in here with those articles from the Pittsburgh Courier and shared them with Walter 5X, and Walter 5X out there in the prison yard teaching and sharing with everybody else, I would have never got out of prison. I'd have been dead. If it don't be from articles of the Pittsburgh Courier, Malcolm bring them in there to Walter. I either would have been in the graveyard or either doing 100 years in prison. Because Walter made it plain. He said, you don't come to this table, you ain't getting out of here. Because he knew my mentality. It's a sick mentality. Crazy. The way he said, ignorant. Don't give a damn about nothing. I'm this, I'm that. To hell with this, to hell with that. He said, you don't come to this table, you ain't getting out of here. He made that plain to me more than once. And I'm so glad, oh Lord have mercy. I'm so glad I listened to him. And he started sharing that with me. And I became fanatic in there with the teachings. And the teachings is what saved me. Because I had a damn near kill two inmates twice. Twice. And when you take a barbell and beat somebody damn near half to death in the yard, the worst thing you can do is to create a disturbance in the yard or in the mess hall. Twice. If it weren't for them teachings, I would have been never got out of there. I'd have been dead. And it was the presence of Malcolm coming inside that prison. One or twice a week to see Walter. And I'm at that table with the other brothers. And they knew that if they got to Malcolm, that they would have brutalized us like they thought they was going to do, try to do anyway. And that would have went all over the world. They didn't want that. That's the only thing that saved me. That's the guard on the street. The guard on the street. Okay. You see? I'm just want to give you understanding of these teachings. We all make mistakes. Just look in the mirror and say, like I did. I would look in the mirror one day and say, Mel, Frenchy, Scopio, you ain't never been making an ass out yourself. I said to myself, you ain't doing about making an ass out yourself. And you ain't hurting nobody but yourself. And when you go in the graveyard, you're gonna be by yourself. And if you get 100 years in prison, but in here, you're going to be by yourself. Now, how you like that, Frenchie, Scorpio? How you like that? Can you deal with that? You got a wife and four children out there waiting on you? So y'all don't know my story, because I don't even talk about it. Because if I told you my story, if they put my story, my life story on TV, it'd blow your mind. It would blow your mind if you knew my activities, my life experience out there in them streets in the world. It would blow your mind. You don't even know me. You know me as Brother Melchizedek. You don't know me as Scorpio. You don't know me as Frenchie. You don't even know how cold and deadly I could be. I put that aside with humor. Humor. That's why I seem to always keep a humorous personality. Come on now. I don't take advantage of nobody. I help everybody. Ain't nobody. Nobody can tell you they came to me. It was a need, and I was in a position, and I didn't help. Nobody can say that. Nobody. Because I know what it is to be in hell. I know what it is to be in situations where you need help and assistance. I understand that. Right to this day, brother, all these different prisoners write me for lessons. I mail lessons all over the country. All them, you ain't got a prison out there. I ain't mail lessons. They write Chicago, Fontaine. Yeah, the manager. Chicago, Final Call Building. They write them all the time for newspapers. He won't even send them a Final Call newspaper. I got the letters. Yeah. Which we try to cut, don't even respond. They write me. I never say nothing. All I do is what? I put lessons in a book and an envelope and mail it to them. Now, some prisons, they used to get they would allow them, and a lot of people, they would allow it in there now. So, being that the Nation of Islam, the five ascendants, the gods and earths, and you're going to give credit to my family, the gods and earth, because that's my family. And I know their qualifications, and I know what they did. And I know what they're still doing all over the country. I ain't going to never forget the 5%. Because 5% lit up New York. They went into all the projects in New York. If you ain't got a project in New York, the God's Earth wasn't in there. Them warlords like old man Saladin and Kusar and Rajab, okay, Black Messiah, Uhuru, Lord Grace Malik Allah, Father Bashan, Minister Raheem, and the Minister, Reality, Akbar, come on, Father Divine, name them, I know them all. I know them all, on the one and one, know them all. Papa Wu, Freedom, huh? What about, what's the other one? Allah Be Man, Mount Vernon, powerful. Okay, Nigeria. Najee, no more. I can't name all of them. I know. All of Katanga. They're all young. I know when they was young, teenagers. Coming to the store for lessons. All they want lessons. And going forth, every project center was a what you call a universal class. Every project center, in the park, in the street, on the rooftop, 42nd Street, all over the place. Fort Greene Park. You know how big that park is? They used to fill it. Fill the park. Babies. 12, 16, 17, 18, 19. Mr. Franklin was in Boston. He wasn't there. He stayed in New York a little while after Malcolm taught him. He went to Boston. Them Bobs and Kevin Rowland. Man, you kidding me? They laid the foundation right in New York. Why do you think New York is so powerful? I don't care what kind of situation is in New York. The teachers, they survived. The Valley of the Gods. Nobody gets popular until they come to New York. And Malcolm laid the foundation in New York, whether you like it or not. I'm going to tell you who named the foundation. It was Malcolm. With the lessons. And the father. You don't like that. But it's true. With the lessons. Keep out in the street and share the lessons. Okay? Which is the teachings of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. The teachings of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. And Malcolm, and the father. When he left, I picked it up behind him. He laid it. He started it. I came behind him with the lessons. Two locations. Utica Avenue, 417 Utica Avenue, and what did I think? And the other one's on 116th Street in 7th Avenue. distribution center for the lessons. I have them stacked up like that. Everybody came in there, got the whole package. Xerox. When in book form was Xerox. Everybody know that. Now you think Johnny come lately gonna come and change that? You can uproot that foundation. That's all over the world. Every prison system, the lessons is there. You know, I meant to tell you that the at one time, I was flooding the lessons with all the prisons with the lessons, but then the five ascendants, okay, got so large, this lesson got so powerful, then some of the institutions start blocking the lessons. Okay, sometimes they send it back, and some that they're just discarded, and then the five ascendants, okay, they would fill out the written so forth. Discrimination, all that, for their religious rights to be practiced, you know, and receive the literature in prison. They went through all that. Okay? And I'm going to tell you something else. The five ascendants got more wisdom than the Muslims in the temple, in the mosque. You got more wisdom in the street than you got in the mosque. Actual fact. No disrespect. I'm not here to disrespect nobody. Well, sometimes they smoke. I don't care what they do. They got them lessons. And he's sharing it. One thing about 5%, he shares it. Okay? And he goes to prison and teach it and share it. He don't go in there and act like he don't know or scared to say he's a 5% or he's a what you call a Muslim. He going in, I'm God. Straight up, God. You could never hear no 5% say he's not God. Got the knowledge, but you only got the lesson. It's still like 91 and 20. If you're on our website for 23 years, there were the 5%, it said some just good and some just bad. But you all got knowledge yourself. Different level, but the same knowledge. See? I'm just giving you all this little information. Stop it. Freedom, justice, and equality amongst us as a people. Respect. Share the wisdom. You're on YouTube. You're on Facebook. You're on Instagram. You're on Twitter and all that. Whatever wisdom you have of the teachings of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, what he said, put it on that channel. Put it out there. You have a resurrection overnight. If everybody flood that mass media with the teachings of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad. My website been out there for 23 years. That website was put together 23 years ago. All them listeners on there, they've been there. And guess what? When they call me once in a while. I want to know if I want to add more to the website and all that. And they respect it. When I call them to pay me, they do that. I just know, well, what you ask your account number, and your name. Mel Church, about love. Oh, Nation of Islam, how you doing? How you doing, Mel Church? How you doing, Mel Church? I said, I'm fine. What you gonna do? I said, I'm calling the payment like I always do. Okay, hold on just a minute. They run it through. Pay. Okay. See you next month. For 23 years. Now they want to update it. Want me to add more to it. I said, that's okay. I'll let you know when I'm ready. I'm going to leave it like it is. Because now I got all out of in the books and all that kind of stuff. Yeah. So anyway, stop the foolishness. Stop the foolishness. Okay. Let's stay focused. On the messenger's birthday. The New York, check this out. The New York City Council. This ain't no Marston. Marston had nothing to do with this. I make that plain. Not me. I had nothing to do with it. Nothing. Julian Tafar. I can't pronounce his last name. Tafar. I'll just say Shabazz Allah. Julian. In the New York City Council. Is the one that made it possible for the renaming of the street, 127th Street and Malcolm X Boulevard. They is the one that made it possible. All due respects to Mars number 7, but Mars number 7 had nothing at all to do with the renaming of 127th Street, where the Mars is at, and Malcolm X Boulevard. Okay, all is welcome. But I want to give credit where credit is due and respect where it's due. It was Julian Tuffer. Oh, I can't pronounce. Julian, if you was out there, just call in after I finish and give your last name. But for now, I'll just say Julian Shabazz Allah, because it took a Shabazz Allah to go through the channel and the changes and so forth to make this happen. The most honorable Elijah Muhammad's way. And check this out. And if we stay and follow the most honorable Elijah Muhammad's way, we will be successful in all our undertakings. The reason why we're not where we're supposed to be today, because we didn't stay in the direction of the way of the teachings of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. We detoured. You detoured? Yeah, you detoured. Come on. And you fell down. This ain't no Arab religion. The hell you get? Arabs don't give a damn about you. I don't give a damn how many nightgowns you put on. Arabs don't give a damn about the lost foundation of Islam in America. And all these rich Negroes who's in position to do something in their community for the people, they don't give a damn about you either. So by you whining and dining and socializing with them, they don't care nothing about you. If they did, they got the money. They ain't got to give you no money. Just do something in the community. When you got money, you don't need nobody to put up a supermarket. Why a supermarket? A supermarket accommodate the whole community. A laundromat accommodate the community. What's needed? A supermarket, a laundromat, a dry cleaner, a barber shop, a beauty salon, daycare center, senior citizen center, educational center. All this is the needs of a community. You got $1 billion sitting in your slave master's bank and he laughing at you. The only time you can come there and get money to buy something is when you want to buy a car. Two cars, three cars, four cars, ain't driving none of them. You got some jackasses out there. They got 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 20 cars. And then the jackass go by a goddamn airplane. Now, how dumb can you get? White man left. The richest black America is the richest black people on earth. Coming together. And producing nothing. Who's in your community? Chinese selling more rat, cat, and dogs and white rice. Rat, cat, dogs, and white rice, and making money in your face in your community. Yeah, right across here from the church. Arabs, alcohol, drugs, pork, and tobacco, marijuana, in your community, right in front of your face. And you down on your hands and knees praying with that desert rat, a dog. You. What about the Korean? Nails and eyebrows, all that stuff. You got the beauty salon, you can't do your own nail? Africans, braiding. Yeah, your grandmother told you how to do corn braids on that braid then. Cut your hair, go buy hair, and then pay somebody to sew it in. Look how dumb you are. In your face, in your community. Now we got the sneakers. used to be $20. Now you're paying $200, $300 for sneakers. Damn, you don't pay that much for sneakers. You have to wear alligators. just wear alligators. Listen. Kids game. Usher. That's kind of, if you're going to spend that kind of money for sneakers. $100 for jeans? What happened to the slaps we used to wear? Shark skin slaps and mohair slaps and all that kind of stuff. We don't wear that no more. Jeans. Now I got the jeans with the holes in the knees. What the hell? You see how we become? Fell in America. America is falling, and we falling in it before the final destruction. Wake up. Get it together. Stop being so stupid. The whole world is laughing at you. Anytime you get up there with a Bible and a Quran and you ain't got no agenda, here you got a Bible in one hand, a Quran in the other, stand on the prayer rug with no agenda. Right, what's your agenda? We're trying today, and we're trying, and we're trying. You got to have an agenda. You got to have an economical program. You have to have a progress report. And you have to have a financial report. People want to see, but the word is out. Everybody talking, but nobody's walking. Because you ain't doing it. You can't show nothing. You sitting in a building 5, 10, 15, 20 years, and all you got is a Bible or a Quran. You went back to sleep. Obama put you back to sleep with a cell phone. A cell phone. Put you back to sleep. And then open the door for gay rights and same-sex marriage. He did that. He did that. The Clintons, they instituted three strikes, you out. Because prison is big time manufacturing business. All the factories and stuff that closed down, got the prisoners making those mokers. God knows, I was a shoemaker. I make shoes. They make shoes, the garbage can, license plates, garbage can, all that stuff is made in prison now. So when you were out in the street, you get maybe $20, $25 an hour, and there you get 50 cents or a dollar a day. A day. No benefits, no sick time, no holidays, no medical coverage, nothing. Big business. The messenger had the plan. Brother, you slept on the messenger. He had it together. But being spooky, he was a businessman, powerful, economical businessman with a third grade education, and here you got a PhD and can't even run a goddamn candy store. Excuse my expression. You out there running your mouth. P, a doctor this, doctor that. Ain't got nothing to show for it but a piece of paper that your slave master gave you saying a degree. I'm a doctor. Who the hell tell you the doctor? Your slave master. Who tell you? You got the degree. Everything you got, your slave master. With all the degree, you still got your slave master's name and still eating chicken. And you going to doctors and still smoking? Still eating chicken? Slave master's name? But you a doctor. So what the hell did you learn in school and university? Nothing. You ain't learned nothing. And when you come out, you're so dumb, you ain't got, when you get a little knowledge, you're still carrying the same old slave master's name with a doctor's degree? You need to shut up and stop making a fool out yourself. had the most honorable Elijah Muhammad with third grade education known all over the world with supreme knowledge, wisdom, understanding that nobody can top what he said. Oh, but you don't want to listen to him. I listen to him, brother. That's why I'm untouchable. From his teachings, you can't count me. But his teachings. And I make it plain all over the world. 190 countries. Documentary. Malcolm X, Muhammad Ali, and the most unblind drama. I make it plain in front of the world. In front of 190 countries to show the love, respect, and appreciation that I have for my spiritual father, the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. I make it plain without the teachings of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad, Melchizedek Supreme Shabbat Allah is just another nigga. But that's all the hell I was before I got his teachings. You do that? You do that? Some of you Negroes out there want to act like you had all the time. But you want to use his name. Because if you don't use his name, you won't even be noticed. Anybody that think they know some more than the messenger, use your name. Don't use his name. Use your name. You only have five people listening to you. So let's get busy. Stop the foolishness. You fell. Get the hell back up. America's fallen, and we fell in America. Get the hell back up. Allah is all beneficent and all merciful. If you're going down the highway and you know you're going the wrong way, all you got to do is make a U-turn. And when you make that U-turn, all you got to do, bear witness to Almighty God Allah, came the person of Master W.D. Farah Muhammad, the only God. And besides him, there is no God. And his last great only messenger is the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. And the two most greatest, MGT and GCC in this nation, is Queen Clara Muhammad and Queen Bernstein Sharif Muhammad. Because those two MGTs was close to Almighty God, the Universal Most High God, in the person of Master W.D. Farah Muhammad. Those two women was very close to him, and everybody know it. Don't you ever try to overlook these pioneers in their performance. All these MGT classes. And to that sister, we give a shout to Sister Charlotte, the one with the canning program. You're doing an excellent job. I know you may not disagree on everything I'm saying. Don't worry about that. I understand what you're doing. You're doing an excellent job. Keep up the good work. Stay focused. Forward ever. Backward never. Don't stop until you're on top. When you get on top, keep it moving. Always do your best, and Allah will do the rest. And have patience, because those sisters yet don't even know the value and the importance of what you're trying to share with them. And some of them be out there starving if they don't listen to you and learn canny. All you MGTs out there, if you don't know canny, stop being so dumb, stupid, and jealous and learn canny, because that's the only way you're going to be able to feed your family when the chaos hit the street, because you won't be coming out in the street. Okay, remember that. No, Chesedek, Supreme Shabazz Allah is telling you that. And all you officials out there, stop wasting time on these Qurans and Bibles and teach the survival of what's coming down the tube. You need to know that. If the Bible, then that goddamn Bible ain't gonna feed your family. That Quran ain't gonna feed your family. You gotta know how to put things in place so you and your family can eat, because chaos gonna hit the street. You can see it building up now. You see all the people laying out in the street now? Where you think gonna go when it get cold? Huh? When 10 degrees and 15 degrees and 10 degrees, all that come cold. They'll be coming to your house. Don't all them churches out there? They're gonna fill them churches up overnight. Take the preachers and throw him the hell out of there, and they're gonna go in there and go to sleep. All these pantries out there, they're running low. They're running low. You think the pantry gonna last forever? Huh? You start feeding a couple hundred thousand people every week and see how much food you have left at the end of the week. Okay. Now back to prayer. I want you to understand. I have nothing against prayer in the privacy of your home, because prayer is a personal communication between you and your Allah and your family. I definitely do not go along with you outside your house, down your hands and knees, playing with a desert rat, a dog that's selling alcohol, drugs, pork, and tobacco in your community and right across the street from your mosque or masjid. That's a no-no. Anybody that can't understand that? I can care less. Okay? Now, to my father. Whew. My father. I want y'all to, if y'all can't understand it, hey, it ain't your fault, but I want you to know, the most honorable Elijah Muhammad is the only father I ever had. I never had a father. A man brought me in the world and left. Okay? I was a baby. Left. Okay? Never had a father. Most honorable Elijah Muhammad is my father. And I can say he's my father. And can't nobody interfere with that. And I can prove that he's my father. More so than what you would call his biological children. Or what else he got? Because for 63 years, I've been upholding the teachings of my father. Word for word. Right and exact, I never add to it, I never take away from it, just like he said it and shared it, his teachings, all over the country and all over the world, okay? And y'all know that. So don't you come in my face about these teachings, okay? That's my father. Okay, and anybody who feel or think there is a son on the level like I am with my father, show me your works, actions, and deeds. And everybody know I was out in the street, not just in the sunshine. In the rain, the snow, and the cold, 10, 12 years. Everybody knows that. Uphold the teachings of my father and the minister. When y'all was home behind closed doors eating bean soup and bean pies. Now you gonna come and question me? You gonna talk to me? When you come to me, you better show respect. If you can't show respect when you to Melchizedek, you do yourself a favor and stay the hell out my face. And all those that think they are bullied, trust me, don't even go there. Don't even go there with me, because you don't want your name on what they call it, a dismissed list. You ever heard of the dismissed list? You don't want your name there. I respect everybody, but I do what I do, and I'm not stopping what I do. I've been doing it too long, okay? And there's no way I'm gonna stop now. I've been in this world too long. I went through too much. I ain't going to my life story. I don't want to think I'm bragging on that. You don't even know my life story, but I guarantee you, most of you never even experienced what I experienced in life. You don't get to be 87 years old. Never shot, never cut, never punched in my face. Okay? I got a track record. And my track record is respected. Trust me. Look, if you don't want to go to heaven, just like I respect you, you respect me. As long as I respect you, respect me. If you disagree with what I'm saying, I can care less, because I don't need you for nothing. I'm independent. I'm God. I'm God if I got something. I'm God if I ain't got nothing. You don't see me out here begging. You don't see me out here homeless. Because if I ain't got, I know how to get. Trust me. I know how to get. But I love the direction. The way of my father, civilized, cultured, refined, highly intelligent, neat, clean, organized, respectable, class, and principled. I like that. I like his way. And that's why I try to continue his way to the best of my ability. I ain't perfect, but I like his way. And there's only one way, today and tomorrow. And that's the teachings of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. What he said. What he said. Anything else, you put that in the garbage can, because it didn't give you no life. Because if it gave you life, you'd be alive now. Okay? So to my father, my only father, my dear, dear, dear father, I love you. I respect you. You're all I need. All I got to have. All I can't do without. Happy birthday. Let the world say happy birthday to the most honorable life. In every newspaper, Pittsburgh Courier, Final Call, Amsterdam, I don't care what newspaper out there, show your love and your respect for the greatest man that ever walked the planet Earth besides Almighty God Allah, who came the person of Master W.D. Farah Muhammad. Show your love and respect, because everybody, I don't care what organization, I don't care where you are, he opened the door for everybody, and you know that. He opened the door for the music world. He opened the door for the movie world and the musical world. Yeah, you opened up the religious world. Some preachers were so scared years ago, they wouldn't even use the word black. So when it comes from the sports world, the musical world, the religious world, entertainers, all them, them rappers out there didn't get open no door. He opened that door for all of them. And then if they got where they want to go, what they do? Sold they soul and they hold for 30 pieces of gold and became a bunch of Illuminati faggots. And that's why now that homosexual thing is all out of control now. Because you're having your songs. You got in front. That could go came out the closet. Anytime you want to be a millionaire, just come out the closet and say, I'm gay. You come out the closet Monday, and you're a millionaire Tuesday. Because you're promoting homosexual activity. Yeah. Okay. Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, all I can say, thank you. I'll always love you. I'll always do what I can to uphold you. Because you are truly my father. Okay, and I teach my children that. All my children knows that that's my father. Okay? I don't hide nothing. And I've got heavy children. Okay? I've got son named Messiah. I got grandson named Messiah. I got grandson named Elijah Muhammad. Okay? I got granddaughters, Kalia and Mecca and all that. All those righteous names. My children got them. Okay? And I didn't need no permission to name my children. I'm God of my family. And everybody know what I stand for. And they all watching now. I don't play. When I'm with them, I'm just grandpa. The only time they see me like this is when I'm on, when I'm doing an interview. I'm on YouTube. Well, anyway, Baba, love you. Did an excellent job. Open up. Open up the chat. I'm ready. I want everybody out there, all of y'all out there, call in with anything you have dealing with what I was speaking of this evening. Call in and feel free to ask me questions about anything. That goes for all ministers, all captains, all lieutenants, secretary, the council, the administration, laborers, officials. Call in. I'm your brother. With respect, call in and let's put the teachings of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad on the table and let's see if we're going, how you say, the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad's way. Okay. As-salamu alaykum. Baba, open up the chat.
Yes, sir. I have one question. In light of the fall of America, regarding charlatans, liars, cheats, scammers, child molesters, and pedophiles. When these individuals are shown up to the community, how should black people, not only the black community, but all communities, how should we deal with those type of persons once they are made manifest?
Okay. It should be eliminated. Trials, juries, all that sometimes is a waste of time. When a person, a pedophile, a murderer, somebody, an elderly person, or whatever crucial crime that's committed, and they're found guilty, why waste the time of giving them 10 years, 5, 15 years? You're wasting taxpayers' money. But prisons have become a big business. That's another way for employment for the slave master's children. So in order for them to get money from the state and the government, if you have a prison, say, that holds 500 inmates, each inmate might be worth, I think, I don't know how many thousands a day, but they get enough, they get money. They get money to support the institution. So that's a job for all, mostly for the slave master's children. Now, like you go to Dannemora, Comstock, Greenhaven, all them upstate individuals, that prison there is the employment for everybody of that community. You understand what I'm trying to say? Now, it's one thing, Lord, that Yaqub may had that I respect. Yaqub didn't build no prison houses. Whoever fell victim to the war, the law under Yaqub, the penalty was death and was enforced on every individual. Me, myself, anyone that's guilty, fair trial and guilty, you should be put to death. A pedophile should die. A person who molested an elderly person, die. Whatever crucial crime that's made and you're found guilty with a justifiable trial, if you're found guilty Monday, you should die Tuesday. Stop wasting the taxpayers' money. We're working to take care of our families. Now we're not working to take care of criminals. Okay? I believe in that 100%. Okay? And it should be televised. Okay? A pedophile, put that execution on TV. Have a special program to let the people know what's going to take place if you do this. Yeah, a channel. Put on a channel. An advertisement. Thursday, Channel 7, whatever channel, let it be publicized that when you're found guilty for a crime, pedophilia, assault, murder, whatever, if it's actual fact, that person should be put to death. Just that simple. That's how you, hey, I can cure. Say you got 20 crackheads. 20 lined up. Crackhead, I can cure 18 in 2 seconds. All I would do is blow the brains out of two of them. Bam, bam. Now the other 18 is not going to use crack no more. They cure. See, reality is the cure. When you know you're going to die for what you do instantly, you ain't going to do it. But if it's going to be prolonged, understood, sympathized, all that, hey, you ain't going to get the message. You understand what I'm trying to say? That's the law. Nobody is above the law. And scamming, if you're scamming people for thousands of thousands, all the kind of monies and all that kind of stuff, you got within 30 days or 60 days, whatever, to replace them, reimburse them their money. If that money is not reimbursed within a certain length of time, you need to die. I believe in execution on everybody. Nobody is above the law. If it's your mother, if it's your father, if it's your son, I don't care who it is. Execution. If you violate the law. Next.
The fall of America, sir, in light of all of the wickedness that has gone on in America, is there any way out? Can the fall of America be avoided?
Yeah. Okay. The reason why the fall of America is because you have weak administration, weak laborers, and weak officials. You got people in position that's too weak to uphold the rules and regulations and principle of the position. You understand what I'm trying to say? All right, take New York. Here you the mayor of New York. Here's a cracker from Texas. Don't notify you. Don't find out if you can accommodate people. Don't find out if you have room for people. Just send busloads to your city without notifying you about anything. And you accept that because you're weak. You're supposed to fill them buses with gas and turn the buses around and send them back where they came from. But when you're weak, you ain't got that kind of mentality. That mentality comes from God, brother. You got to have an understanding of God because God means power and force. You don't let nobody come in your house and dictate to you when you got the power. Wait. So you stand there making all the excuses. Now you're stuck. Now you got buses coming every day. Now you got them coming from Venezuela now. They're coming. And where he at? He over there in Mexico sympathizing with them. Now, there's nothing wrong with helping people. Charity starts at home first and then spreads abroad. Okay? But no, you want to take care of the outside and neglect the inside. And the inside was the one that built up the situation already. The inside built up New York, not outside. Inside. But now the people who worked in New York, their retirement, their pension or whatever, now you're going to cut them short for somebody that came from the outside. Here's the, let me see. Here's the doctors, the nurses, the doctors, the school bus drivers. They all got to go on strike to get an increase. Now, these are working people. Working people that are paying taxes, city tax, state tax, federal tax, for years. They got to go on strike to get a few dollar raise. They got to go on strike. But you got money to assist other people who just came in on a bus. Now you got to provide food for them, clothes for them, fill out job permits, housing. Hotels is making big money, $1,000 a day for a room and all that kind of stuff, because you're weak. And the problem is, Baba, weakness. Always want a position that they don't have enough strength to uphold. So in situations like that, it's not the rank and file. The people are working. It's the administration, laborers, and officials. Weak. And that's what the fall of America is about. Weak administration. Now, everybody know Biden. No disrespect. The man is dimensional. You see now, you don't know what the hell he's doing. How you going to send billions, $5 to $6 billion to Ukraine? And you got people in America, down in California, sleeping in the street for years? You understand what I'm trying to say? And then Ukraine is coming here. So what the hell are you sending money over there for, and you're still letting them come in here too? Weak administration, officials, and labor. And all these organizations that's not doing something constructive for the people and in position to do something are weak administration, officials, and laborers. Next.
Well, sir, that ended my two questions that I had. I'm looking in the chat to see. Come on, y'all. Do you have any questions that you would like to ask Melchizedek while we have him here?
And nobody is above the law. I like Trish James. Trish James made it plain to Donald Trump. No matter how much money you got, no matter what your name is, no matter who the hell you are, you're not above the law. The law applies for everybody. Okay. Bob, you mean to me you got to buy the chat, bro?
Okay, here's one. Someone asked, aren't South Central America, Caribbean, part of our original family? I guess they're speaking of the,
All the Caribbean islands is our family. You understand what I'm trying to say? You can assist them build up their country where they can stay in there, because people don't want to come here because they love America. They come here because that's for survival. So if you want to help somebody, build up where they're at so they can enjoy their own homeland. You understand what I'm trying to say? You talk to the average person that comes to America, they tell you straight up, I'm only here for a better life, for survival, because the opportunities here is not in my country. But America, how much money is spent over there in Israel every year? They build countries all over the world. So build up the Caribbean countries. Okay? When you go there and build up hotels, gambling, and gambling casinos and restaurants. That's what they build. Why don't they build some houses? Build some houses. If they build some houses and create employment there, most of these people that's here wouldn't come here. They love their country. Now they say, well, I think Jamaica now, they got an area where they can't go to the beach no more. What? You're a native of Jamaica. You're born, raised. Now you can't go to the beach because somebody's building a hotel for all the tourist resort thing. No. Build up. When people need help, you're in position. Build up where their country. And they build, you go everywhere, all they got hotels, restaurants, and gambling casinos. Why don't they build some houses? That's employment. You need people to build up houses, need people to live in it. If you create employment, the people won't be coming here. Who the hell want to come to America? America is the worst damn place to live. Crime rate. Look at the crime rate. Where'd that come from? Weak administration. Well, what can we do about it? Create jobs for the young brothers. Young brothers making $500-$600 a week. He ain't going to be out there robbing nobody. No, you don't do, no. You, that's, it's always the city, the state, and government officials, brother. That's the corrupted 10% mentality. Rich get rich and poor stay poor. Now they stuck because they stuck with a situation where the point where ain't nobody going to have nothing. Either everybody going to have something or nobody going to have nothing. That's the position they're in now. And they're afraid. They're afraid. Trust me. America is afraid because her house is shaking. It's the fall of America. Her house is shaking because she don't want to do right by the people. And until she do right by the laws down in Islam in America, she will always have problems. Because Allah is wiping it out. Leveling it, cities, not cities. Okay? But leveling it. And with New York, they better be careful. Because all those skyrise buildings, 40 stories, 50 stories, one earthquake, all them buildings will come down on the people's head. One earthquake. So they better get together. Okay. Next.
Okay, Brother Shay. And Krumah asked Melchizedek, is this the start of World War III or the Great Reset?
No, this is the Great This is not, and you can call it World War III, but Allah called it the War of Armageddon. This is the War of Armageddon. Or World War III is on, or like Mr. Franklin said, I think a couple of elections ago, the world, Armageddon had just begun. Now I'm going to tell you when Armageddon started. When Almighty God Allah, in the person of Master W.D. Farad Muhammad, stepped his foot into America, that's when the war of Armageddon started. Okay? And the only reason why he didn't wipe it out then, because his uncle, the Lord's Foundation of Islam, Shabazz Allah, his uncle, which is us, okay, because his father is the universal most high God, all wise and powerful. But he came in the shape, form, and fashion of Master W.D. Farad Muhammad to give the lost down nation of Islam in America a chance, give him justice to receive the universal divine supreme wisdom that they're entitled to bring here and leave it with the first begotten of the dead, was the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. Now, what makes the most honorable Elijah Muhammad so powerful? And you hear me say this over and over. If you put all the prophets together, all the wise men together, all the angels together, all the every man on earth, prophets, imam, I don't care how many Qurans you're reading, I don't care how many Bibles you're reading, whatever. You put them all together and they get down on their hands and knees. They don't qualify. No man, none qualified to shine his shoes, kiss his feet, sit in his seat, or sit on his toilet stool. Do you hear me? Okay. Why you say that, Melchizedek? Because the most honorable Elijah Muhammad, the last and greatest only messenger of Allah, was the only one in the last 66 trillion years was able to recognize the universal most high God in the person of Master W.D. Farad Muhammad. Nobody was able to recognize him. And that's an actual fact. And if anybody opened their mouth, talk about they this or they that. Ask them, did you recognize Almighty God Allah in the person of Master W.D. Farad Muhammad? And was you taught by Almighty God Allah in the person of Master W.D. Farad Muhammad for 3.5 years, not just in the temple, but after the temple, in his car all night long? If you ain't got that kind of experience, due to all respect, I'm talking to the world, keep your
goddamn mouth shut and bear witness that there's no God but Allah, who came to purse of Master W.D. Farad Muhammad and his last refuge is the most honorable Elijah Muhammad, and nobody is qualified to take his place. Peace. Next.
Melchizedek, I think that did it, sir. I don't see anybody coming with any more questions. I think that you summed it up as you always do on this most prestigious birthday of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. I don't see any more questions. You taught, Melchizedek. When you teach, people don't have, you answered most of their questions.
Bob. But where's all these Quran readers? All these Quran readers, all these Bible readers, all these ministers, captains, lieutenants, no disrespect. Now, I'm not disrespecting nobody. I'm just asking a question. The council, where you at? I'm just your brother. I'm not here. No disrespect. I'm not here to disrespect nobody. I'm only repeating the teachings of my father, the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. With respect, you mean to tell me you ain't got no questions? If you ain't got no questions, then bear witness that Almighty God Allah came to the person of Master W.D. Farad Muhammad, and his last, greatest, and only messenger is the most honorable Elijah Muhammad, and uphold his teaching. You understand? The teacher's teaching. And share whatever wisdom you have. Teach the teachings of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad, word for word, right exact. Don't add to it. Add to it, just like you said it. If you bear witness that Almighty God Allah came to person of Master W.D. Farad Muhammad, just teach his teachings, word for word, right next to that. Don't add to it. Don't take away from it, just like he said it. And then continue his teachings and do what we have to do, what he told us to do, do what he told us to do. Stay focused. Forward ever, backward never. Don't stop until we're on top. When we get on top, we keep it moving, and all we do is praise Allah in the person of Master W.D. Farad Muhammad. Do our best, and Allah will do the rest. And all we got to do, all of us, I want the world to say, happy birthday, dear holy apostle, the most honorable Elijah. Next.
And on that note, Melchizedek, I think we better end it. The reception is getting kind of bad, and I don't want us to go out. I want to quit while we're ahead because the reception is getting kind of shaky. You'll be starting to break up now. Yes,
okay,
sir.
Okay.
So I want to, because your sound started going in and out. We've been doing good, but the sound just recently started going in and out. So I don't want us to end up going out. So I think we ought to quit while we're ahead. You know how this internet is.
Baba, can we all say happy birthday, dear honorable Elijah Muhammad?
Yes, sir. Happy birthday to the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. Peace.
Peace.